Hey, what are you trying to do? She's ducking out of the photograph.
She's on yard duty.
Is that what you've been cleaning up? And here's old George.
Hello, John. Why don't you get a picture across the street of where Bailey's used to be?
Sounds good. It's now New Chinatown.
Dairy Queen is now Ida's. It's out of business.
Yeah, it used to be Bailey's. And that's way down there. What's it? The country cooking place?
Yep.
It used to be the Dairy Queen.
Curry Thomas.
Hardware
Supply.
That used to be right there on the corner. You remember?
Uh-huh. Yeah. It took up several of those.
Yeah. And then there was a Mac Michaels or Carmichael's little sundry place where you could get sandwiches and drinks.
I remember that at all.
I remember him from camp. His son went to camp with him.
Curry Thomas is still over in St. Nicholas.
Yeah. And Bay Meadows too.
Is it?
Yeah.
Were there some other restaurants close by? Were there,
what was they had the roller stand of that was a little before my time.
You see, there was one down here by the car dealership that used to really be a bad place.
Oh, I do remember that, but I don't remember.
Leo Pagonis lived behind. Can't think of it.
You remember that pole, George? Remember what we did on that pole there?
Pole. A pair of panties every now and then.
Yeah. Remember senior skip day?
Yeah.
Did you see that on senior skip day?
I don't remember that.
We put the girls' panties up on the top, raised them to the top, and then greased the pole. That was a tradition every senior year.
A tradition for you guys.
Well, that's tradition.
Well, for some girl it was, too. Somebody had to fork over the panties.
Did you get a different pair of panties every year?
Yeah,
or what?
Yeah.
Nobody wanted to claim it.
I think it was the same girl. We get in this way?
Yeah.
Let me try. Go ahead, George. I think we have to get a key to that. They told me that they have to keep the kids out of there so they can keep it clean.
Well, you can get a good picture through it. Mm-hmm. At our pep rallies here on Friday, Pop would predict that Jackson would beat the Green Bay Packers.
Let's see.
It looks nice. Yeah.
Do y'all remember who Miss Jackson was?
Yeah, it was Judy, wasn't it?
Judy Fry. No, she was homecoming. Who was?
Linda?
Lynn Brower.
Lynn Brower?
Oh, okay, I do remember that. Yeah. That's right. Or was it the other way around?
Yeah. Lynn Brower, I think, is Miss Jackson.
Okay. George, you remember whose classroom this was right here?
No, I remember.
Remember Vincent Exley?
Yeah, yeah. He held the school board. Now,
Americanism versus communism.
Well, I had. I had Mr. McMillan for AC.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, up on the third floor.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, we don't have to worry about Americanism versus communism anymore, do we?
No.
It's just Americanism versus Americanism.
Oh, I think it's the windows looking at us.
Yeah, it's where people sat during the pep rallies.
Mm-hmm.
And we used to have study hall with Coach Peck.
Here's the senior walk, right?
Yep. We're the Yardbirds, and I think the team captain, Buddy Gibbons.
Come over here close so they can hear you, because it's...
It's where all the Yardbirds hung out, and Buddy Gibbons was the team captain of the yard crew. You either got yard duty or a lick for each flash you skipped.
Has Buddy ever been to the room?
But only the seniors could go out there, right?
Yeah, but I mean, I don't remember anybody going out there except yard duty guys.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I don't remember going out there.
Well, y'all must not have gone through the big wheel door then, either.
The big shot door, John.
The big shot, okay.
Yeah.
That was my locker.
That tells you I was never a big shot.
Milton and I came in the back door.
And Miss Welch's office is down here.
Yeah. Yeah, and Edith Haas's mom was the, I think she was the guidance counselor then, wasn't she?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Mr. Lockett, the principal.
Okay. Yeah, you remember Lockett's pockets?
Yeah.
Yes, feeling cool over here.
Yeah. Got air conditioning.
What are you doing peeking in the boys' bathroom?
That's not the boys' bathroom.
Oh, okay.
Gosh. That's the same chairs.
Oh, they reupholstered them.
Professional office education.
Right. And I remember I took no hand in typing and
did
maybe
you?
Second floor across the street from Mom Baker's room.
You remember it being air conditioned when we were here?
No.
Yeah, you opened the windows.
Is this a magnet school?
It could be.
I don't think it's a magnet. It's some kind of special program, though. It's not a...
Richard Raines and I were hall monitors, I think, when I was a 10th grader and he was 11th. Had to check people's hall.
Oh, yeah, you were doing for a hall monitor.
That's right.
I don't remember what my name was.
No.
Back here.
Where the teacher's lounge was? Right across the hall, right back here on the right.
I stayed away from
that. That's right, because of all the smoke.
Yep.
That's the only place you could legally smoke.
We used to have our meetings in there, you know, like student council. Yeah.
And I wouldn't know about that.
And do you remember what Coach Rigetko used to say about smoking in the boys' room?
No. What did he say?
He said, don't do it and throw it in the head because they're hard to smoke the butts after they're wet. And do you know what Rigetko spells backwards?
No.
Okay, Tigers.
Oh, you know, I do. I think I won the slip.
Yeah.
Where are we going?
Well,
way up there.
On the north side.
Well, you want to see the band room and see if it's still out here?
It's that, that's not attached.
And then the gym's back here, too, isn't it?
Yeah. They built that while we were here, right?
Yep.
Building it,
yeah. Yeah, they finished it.
Yeah, I think it was the last year that we were here.
Well, that's what...
Because I think Gary Gann and Chabler and those guys playing basketball right there.
That's the band room right there. I wonder if it's still there.
I bet you that was a shop out there.
Yeah.
And then the field house was back in the shop.
You can see back out here?
No.
Be on the 12 o'clock news.
All right.
ROTC. Oh, I know who was out here. This was geometry. What was his name? You know who the guy was that taught geometry?
Cody taught geometry.
Huh?
He was one of them. Cody.
Trigonometry is what it was. Trig was out here.
I never got
I can picture
trig.
The guy.
I never
you didn't
got
get
the trig, so I can't tell you.
You didn't get the trig? No. I mean, you didn't have a holster with a slide rule in it?
Them smart guys had that.
Print shop was right here.
Yeah.
Yep. You take shop, George?
Not here. I did it, Kirby.
Yeah. You did it, Kirby?
Yeah. I saw the first real good fight out here with Johnny Bowden. Tony Branch.
This is the back of the gym, right?
Oh.
Isn't it?
Johnny Bowden took on Bowden.
He was a
got handball courts here now.
Yeah.
Got a pool.
This was the extent of the buildings when we were here. This is where it all stopped.
This was where they had the track and the football. And the,
yeah,
practice
you practice
field.
Out here. And there was an old brick building back in the way back in the corner.
I think
that
by
was
the time we left that they were doing practice at North Shore Elementary.
Yeah, yeah, because they had built the...
Yeah.
Yep.
The field house
yeah.
was back behind
way
there. Yeah.
Yeah, I remember the first 2 days going out there and puking my
and
guts out.
And do you remember
out.
Who our drum major was back then?
Was it Andre?
Andre Ferrer.
Oh,
yeah.
Andre will be here this weekend.
Yeah, I saw that. Will this be the first time he's been there?
No.
Second, I think. Yeah.
Second time?
Yeah.
The gym was actually here
might have been.
It was. And that was 2 years ago.
You know, I think they built it that year. That was the Danny Lee. That group went undefeated and lost the land.
Right.
And
I remember the game.
Yeah.
You used to ride the city bus to school?
Yeah, Panama 17.
Panama, yes, Panama 17.
North Shore 26, I think.
Yeah, yeah.
I was 15
Phoenix. All right. How much did it cost?
Was it going to be up on 8th Street?
What was it? Oh, yeah, Main Street Drive-In.
Or you could go out to the Reebok Drive-In.
Oh, yeah.
Are there any drive-ins left?
Huh?
Are there any left? Any
drive-ins? Yeah, Playtime.
Playtime?
Yep.
Rattler Hall.
Something about FAMU.
Yeah.
Oh.
These halls look wider, don't they?
Man.
I guess it's the color scheme.
Yeah.
I don't even know if I have questions, but I'm sure I did, but I don't remember.
Wonder if they have one-way halls anymore.
I don't know, we were talking about that earlier.
Were you?
Yes.
But wasn't this where Ma Baker's class was? Somewhere?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. What was that big heavy guy? What was his name? He was an English teacher. Nice guy.
Going in.
Was this Baker's plan?
Well,
close enough.
Her room was double this size, I think.
Yeah, it was.
Don't let that come. I don't want to get locked in.
Oh, don't say it.
No air conditioning.
And what did Ma Baker used to do to
she
the girls?
She had to paddle all the time.
Wasn't she English? I didn't.
Yeah, she was an English teacher.
Well, what'd she do when she paddled the girls, you remember?
Ankle?
No.
I don't know. What'd she do?
She lifted their dresses up and spanked them. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Never got to see that.
I never did.
You missed it.
I missed it.
That's why everybody wanted to be in her class.
Yeah. Yeah, Miss Walker at North Shore used to pull up your pants leg and paddle the back of your calf so you wouldn't mark.
I never got in trouble. I don't know about that.
You didn't get in trouble?
Uh-uh.
And you said you went to Jackson?
I was a mess.
See, now I guess this was the open into the auditorium too. Wasn't
it? They've closed all the windows off.
Did you see how many people that said been sitting there? 500.
500. See if any of these trophies go back to our days.
84, 85, I think we're...
Gee.
Might be getting closer.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think we want any trophies.
The closer we get, the
farther
we get.
Here's our trophy.
Yep. They probably threw all of ours away.
You're right about that gym being open, because I remember Jackson beat Lee when we were in the 10th grade, mm-hmm. 14 to 13.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I remember.
And who was the
Richard
coach?
Kincaid was our quarterback, I think.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
And Coach Stephen Thompson.
Yep. Yeah, you're right.
And then they started chanting the score, and then Lee beat our brains out in basketball.
And this?
Mr. Al Bassett. Had his history class.
I had him, and that's the class they got me out of to interrogate me about who painted the gym walls.
Okay.
You're kidding.
No.
What had they painted on the gym wall?
Initials. I don't know just what.
And that was it?
But it was a brand new gym.
That's true.
It was not a nice thing to do.
Do you remember what Bassett did for a sideline?
He was a coach. That's all I know.
The Jacksonville Robins.
Oh, I didn't remember.
Semi-pro football team.
Oh, I didn't remember that.
I don't even remember that.
And Bill Cranford and I thought we were real tough after getting the lifeguards, and we got caught talking in class, he said, a lick or write 500. So he took us to Mr. Davis's office and hid us from the doorway into the lockers. And, we weren't ready for that.
He wasn't that big a guy.
No, but he was tough.
Yeah. And this is Davis's office, and that's where they took him.
Yeah.
Well,
Al Heckwood.
Heck, that's what it was. He was the one who interviewed.
Wasn't Schemer over here too?
He was our coach, Jack Schemer, at Kirby, and I think he did come.
He did transfer, I think.
Then we got a guy named Coach Ross that came from Landon that lost 27 straight games.
Whoa!
And I think the door was right here to the boys' dean's office.
You must have X-ray vision, George.
I do. No, Cranford Mines head print is still in the
still there where you landed.
Where we got knocked into it.
I think you're right, though.
Yep.
Well, I think we just passed the hallway, too, where you used to hang Robert E. Lee in effigy.
Yeah,
you remember that?
I remember that.
And do you remember what the, was it Beta High Y? Or was it our senior High Y?
Mm-hmm.
Did before the big game, built the bonfire.
Oh, yeah.
Yep, that's right.
That's so awesome. That's right.
I mean, but they let us out of school for a day.
Yeah.
I think everybody in the school joined the club so they could get out.
Yeah, and senior fellows, we met once a year.
Yeah.
In time for the photograph.
Could you have two lockers? One on an upper floor and one on the lower floor?
I don't think so.
I thought I did, or maybe I shared a locker.
You
with
probably shared a locker.
These are obviously not the old lockers that were here.
No. We had full lockers, though, didn't we?
I had full lockers.
Yeah.
And was it the library? Or did you ever go to the library?
I never went to the library.
The library, I think, was on the third floor.
Oh, was it?
Yes, I did. Yes. Because Coach Folsom had study hall in there.
Yeah. Third floor in the same place we are right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
We used to get early lunch in study hall because the cafeteria, if you remember, was up.
It was on the third floor.
On the third floor.
Yeah.
And then they redid it
That's
downstairs.
True.
Food wasn't any better.
True. Yeah, we used to make jokes about how they made their hamburgers. You remember that?
I didn't want to know where they had been.
Well, every time you found a hair, it gave you a hint.
Yeah.
Cow tongues, didn't they make it out of cow tongue?
Yeah. Do you remember Fridays?
Yeah, because it was the end of the week, but other than that, what
how
was
bad
it?
The school smell because of the fish.
Oh, that's right.
Every Friday.
Yeah.
Whether you were Catholic or not,
you had fish. I like fish.
One more level.
That wasn't Mrs. Paul's.
I remember over in North Shore, we didn't do it any over here, but remember Georgetti's dad used to do the spaghetti suppers all the time?
So Wayne got the nickname Spaghetti.
Yep.
Is that where he got it?
Yep.
Oops, we got it. Or out.
Okay, see you later.
This is the way it looked when we were here.
I think this is the one where Richard ran tonight. Just hold the door. I'll check and see.
I think it's probably cleaner this time.
Come on in, John.
Go ahead, John.
We even have private stalls in the men's room.
All right.
Does it smell too smoky?
No. And the floors aren't wet.
Right? You remember when the tough guys used to flush cherry bombs down the toilet?
Oh. Looks like the same window.
I've never lived in here before.
Yeah. I mean, this place is uptown.
It is uptown, really. Okay.
Because back in the old days, there were no doors.
Mm-hmm.
That was really clean.
Yeah.
Wonder where it is now. put all new windows in or something.
See, you know, look at these. These are the full lockers. Them up here. I think we had biology class used to be back here.
Tell you, one of the,
it's a media center now.
Well, it still is, yeah. My goodness.
Even unlocked.
Sure looks a lot better, doesn't it?
We're going to get beeped if we go through here, aren't we?
I don't think they needed these beepers here back when we were in school, because I don't think many books got checked out.
Well, we didn't lose our accreditation until the year after we graduated.
I thought it was the year we graduated.
I thought it was our
Was it that year?
It was December of our senior year.
Yes, it was.
Okay, well, I thought it was the next year.
That's when your parents shipped
you out. That's when Milton and I got shipped out of town to Gordon Military.
Now, I was trying to remember. You're probably one of the most liked teachers. Had a heart attack and died. I believe he was on this floor.
The man.
Yeah, Mr. Mayo.
Mayo, that's right.
Wasn't it on the third floor?
I think it was. Very distinguished looking.
Yeah.
Nice guy.
I was there when it happened.
Speaking of heart attacks,
do you remember what event that we were, where we were when a referee died?
At the game, wasn't it?
The Jackson-Paxson game when Gary Padgett was the quarterback.
Yeah, he died right on the field.
Paxson, the referee, died at about the 50-yard line, and the game was called off.
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah. And where were you guys when Kennedy was assassinated?
I was in the cafeteria downstairs.
What about you, George?
I was around the corner in Miss Thurwell's English class.
Weren't they changing class about the time that happened?
I don't know.
Right at the end of our class.
Yeah.
Right towards the end of our class.
I know she started crying.
Yeah.
I was down on the first floor.
I remember sitting in the balcony of the auditorium, too, and watching the tanks go down Main Street when the Bay of Pigs thing was going on.
I had forgotten all about that.
That was scary.
Mm. There were a lot of things that happened to us when we were...
You would have been a Kirby Smith then.
Well, maybe it wasn't crazy.
Yeah, because Bay of Pigs was the first year he was president in 61.
Yeah.
Okay, well, maybe.
Yeah.
What was it? Don't ask me.
Yeah, but I mean, we were just on 12th and Main instead of 25th and Main.
And where were you when Hurricane Dora hit?
Well, school wasn't even in yet. Yeah, it was right before school
was
in. No, it was right before school was in.
I was in Neptune Beach.
Neptune Beach.
As a lifeguard, we were down there doing sandbags.
Oh, okay.
Trying to secure the lifeguard station.
That was right before our junior year, right?
Right, and then the Beatles concert was that weekend.
Yeah.
And none of the guys would go because they thought they were too cool.
Well, y'all don't know this, but I went to the Beatles concert.
You did?
Yeah, and I was dressed up as one of the Beatles. No joke.
I wish I could have seen that.
You remember, who was it? Johnny Tillotson?
Yeah, very well.
He lived around the street. He lived on Oakwood.
Well, he came into town. If you all recall, I used to do a lot of photography.
Yeah.
And over at the Brad Tredinnick Youth Center.
I remember that.
We met over there, and he said he was doing a little show for everybody. He says, how about you coming and doing the photography? He says, he's like an opening act for the Beatles.
He was the opening act?
Yeah.
And
that's how I got in.
Okay,
he had wigs and everything. That was really cool, yeah. Speaking of cool, I guess that word's come back again, huh?
Yeah. It's not.
It has come back. I even say it sometimes. I know I had classes up here, but I don't remember what they were.
I don't remember
either. This is
hysterical. I know we had Miss Thurwell's class up here somewhere, and she had the type classroom that there was another classroom behind it.
Was that your typing?
Another classroom behind
you. Right. There was a door that you closed in the entrance to the one classroom.
Like that?
It's kind of like this. just like this, John.
Yeah.
Oh. Well, it looks here like they haven't done too much of this room. That's probably it, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is the room, probably.
Yeah, it probably is.
Yeah, I think it probably is.
Now, who was this?
This is Miss Thurwell's class.
And what did she teach?
English.
Oh. English.
I saw her back in the 80s out at Regency. She was still doing fine.
Y'all like the way we got it tore up around here?
Yeah.
It looks good.
This place place
We're
looks.
We're trying to get it clean, though.
This looks normal from when we were in school.
This is cleaned up compared to the 60s when we were here. This place,
really?
This place is nice.
Oh, yeah. Y'all like it?
Oh, we have nowhere.
But you know what, though? We got the type of kids that don't want to see it looking pretty all the time. They got taps up.
We were like that, too, though.
Well, we were talking about when guys used to drop cherry bombs down the toilets pretty regular.
Well, you was here when the little girl went down the stairs?
No, that was later.
That was later?
Yeah, we got out in 65.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I do remember that.
What happened?
I didn't believe it until our supervisor told us. The little girl jumped from the third to the first.
Whoa.
And killed herself.
Intentionally?
Yeah.
And then one girl from here was over in Israel, got her leg blown off.
Yeah.
In about 75.
Yeah.
That's from Jackson. We've had, Governor Burns from here?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Jake Godbold?
Yeah.
Tommy Azuri?
Yeah.
Who else? There's some more mayors. Mm-hmm. Lou Ritter?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So there's been a lot of Jackson.
Jackson got a lot of background.
That's
sure
right.
Does. Way back.
Thank you. looks nice.
We'll be trying.
Is the food still bad in the cafeteria?
That's what they say.
See, that's kind of like,
yeah.
I thought it was on Main Street, but apparently there's no classes here, so it had to be over here.
Yeah, there is some classrooms right there. You have to walk through one to get to the other.
What about this one? Is there one?
That's class? Just a new room they built. That's a computer room.
Okay.
Hmm. Nothing with carpet in there. That's right. The only one with carpet in it. What y'all at, Ms. McQueen?
Is this upstairs air conditioned like the rest of it?
This is always going and never
had
to. Okay.
You have to open the bathroom to get cool.
How you doing today?
Yeah. Bring back old memories.
Yeah. I used to have all the students doing all this back then.
The students used to do it?
A lot of it, because if you got caught skipping, you got
for
each class
you missed. What? Or you got a day of detention. You ever do that?
That's
capital
punishment.
No. Can't spank them no more.
No.
They can cuss you out. You have to send them home. Jail, you're going to jail.
That's when I got out of school.
They used to give us licks from wearing our shirt tails out or not wearing socks.
Yeah. Can't do that
no more.
Y'all have a good day.
You too. Thanks for your help.
Mm-hmm. And what was this thing about collecting shirt loops? You guys collecting shirt loops in the class of 61. Yeah. What was the deal?
I think it was a deal till a few girls got popped in the head. Yeah, the girls
would. What about pull them off?
Yeah.
I didn't.
What about the wrap around skirts? You remember those?
Yeah. It was great when it was windy.
I know. It was flat when it
was windy. Well, I've seen a couple of them hit the ground when classes were changing.
Yeah.
You remember that?
Yeah.
A couple of guys would come back, boing, pull the string. And
that's probably another spot in the room.
I think the name of that restaurant down there we're talking about by Leo Gonis was Al's Drive-In.
Is what?
No, Al's.
Was it
Al's
down there?
Al's
was
where they had the skaters.
Well, you know, the Crystal had skaters too.
Yeah. But there was one up near Kirby Smith that used to have a lot of skaters.
That was a good one.
Yeah, they got a brand new one. They rebuilt it.
Did they have the stalls out?
Yeah. No, they don't have the Drive-In, I don't think.
Were you ever involved in any rappings?
Yes, Tila Maple and her crew came over and did my house, and Milton Chapman and I emptied a case of toilet paper in her tree. And I think there's probably still some TP in the tree.
You think there's still
something
there? That was fun.
Yeah.
That's a funny way to show that you like somebody, isn't it?
Yeah.
throw in toilet paper.
And then if you were lucky, it rained that night.
Yeah.
It'd be there forever.
An odor, isn't it?
Yeah.
I wasn't talking about you, Georgia.
I want you to, this is Miss Mack's room.
Right there?
Our great French teacher.
Well, your French teacher.
French teacher that used to sneak vanilla wafers. And we would wait until she was getting ready to put one in her mouth and we'd scream at her. And she'd start choking on her. But you were talking about sad things that happen. I think one of the sad things that happened were our classmates that got killed over in Vietnam. Barry Gaines. You know, Tim Delaney's brother got killed there. Put Chancey in our class, severely injured. And no telling how many others, I think. Denny Carter got drafted out of high school and went over there. Milton Chapman went to basic and then no training and drove trucks.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Didn't Chris go over there to also?
Probably. Yeah. But I mean, we don't know how many of them went.
Yeah.
But I know our class did its share.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That was scary.
Yeah, it was.
I guess besides the Kennedy deal, that had to be the saddest thing that happened while we were here.
Yeah.
Come with her.
You see it right here.
This is the truth. That won't fit me now.
They don't even know about you in here.
Well, that's okay.
Well, they were supposed to over on the other side, but one more little model there around.
One right.
Oh, okay.
Da-da, da-da. All right.
abortion.
You sure it's all right?
Yeah.
You're positive?
Yeah, I'm positive.
Can you say some things about you now?
Go ahead.
Can you turn it off?
As long as they're lies and they're flattering.
That's right. You're a marvelous person. But if you don't turn that thing off, you're going to have a margarita. Point your turn.
We'll have to have details. You know,
$15
a month or
something.
I mean, that's not uncommon for me.
I tell you, that's a Blue Cross. We can always tell you that one time a year.
Well, he talks about it. No, it's Irish or any man. Doesn't have to be a day.
Isn't that part of the chain language?
Now that'll cost.
But don't stop talking now.
More.
I don't think you want to put that one on, John.
No, that will be on the website tonight.
John. Pervert.
Yes.
There actually is a whole lot of bankrupts.
Is that more fun?
You know what? I hate to say this, and I think that they.
Yes, sir.
I mean, I know that they're hurting because of all this stuff.
He passed away about 14 years ago.
This is their perfect opportunity.
Okay.
Diabetes, he's got Alzheimer's.
Too good looking. Yeah,
why don't you try?
Life doesn't get any better.
As they say, a thorn between two roses.
A rock.
They had to cut one of his legs off.
Okay, John, give me the camera.
Oh, yeah, really?
So that's what we need, just in the hoodie. I go by the morning.
Yeah, didn't they
we wanted to keep working.
He always asks, who are you?
No, I don't think so.
Well, I'm in the all time. Oh, no, you're memory. Memory. I didn't. Did you mean this though? You know, they're trying to get your
memory. Yeah, they're still giving their highest. Their bonus.
No, not really.
Yeah.
That's probably true about that.
Everybody
make a chocolate ice
box.
Chocolate ice
box.
There you go.
No, why don't you intertwine arms and feed each other? Seriously.
Toast. Have you looked at your fork? I'm not doing that.
Well, Jace was limp.
Take it out.
More chocolate?
Yes.
How about dessert? I know everybody's getting a bite. How is it?
That was terrible. Can we have more?
Oh, man. No. What happened here?
It's all over the bag.
Oh, did it come out of the
bag? Sideways. Oh. Can I get another bag?
Yeah, let me go get
it. I don't end it up.
Yeah, let me go get it. That is almost.
Don't even go there. No.
How about you?
Oh,
And then we're going to try. We got through this together now. How you doing, sir? One of the undefeated football players right here. See, so glad to see you, sir. We've got players here. I start coaching now. I'll be in trouble now. From all of our undefeated football teams that we've had in Jackson, I'm so happy for that. But we're gonna get these little presentations out of the way. And Gene Hodges has two things we're going to do. We're going to sing the alma mater and God Bless America. All right. Now, at this time, and in closing, before we get to it, I want to thank the organizations and companies that have helped with this song. Please look at the display. We've got the thank you. Those are Jackson graduates that helped put this together. The flowers here from Bob King and King Flores in his honor. That's an example. And at this time, let's see, I'd like Vicki Drake from the school board to come up. Coach Jackie Simmons, Coach, where are you? Come on up, Coach. You got to hurry. Hurry, Jackie. Hi, Coach Jackie. 1970-71. Jackie is the athletic director at Andrew Jackson. He is the winningest basketball coach in the history of Jackson.
Current and former student teachers and staff. celebrate the 75th anniversary of the graduating ceremony student years for the school seniors, and whereas over the past 75 years, more than 30,000 students have graduated from Andrew Jackson High School. Among them, one governor, one lieutenant governor, Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of Florida, numerous legislators, four mayors, several city council members, school board representatives, police officers, firefighters, professional athletes of the National Football League, the National Basketball League, and Major League Baseball, Grammy award-winning musicians, a Pulitzer Prize-winning author, NASA space engineers, motion picture industry executives and celebrities, as well as scores of teachers, ministers, doctors, attorneys, judges, business leaders, inventors, architects, and countless other good citizens residing in the Duval County, the state, the nation, and throughout the world. And whereas thousands of Jacksonville and Jackson alumni have served in the armed forces of the United States, and more than 300 of its former students have made the supreme sacrifice while serving their country in the preservation of freedom. And whereas this gathering provides an opportunity for new acquaintances, recall memories with special presentation each evening, be it resolved that the Florida House of Representatives, the House of Representatives offers its congratulations to the current and the former teachers, and staff, and students of Andrew Jackson High School. And I'd like to present this now to Ray Moore, a real soldier of the Andrew Jackson type. Ray?
Oh, He was. He went right over there. There in the blue coat. Right here.
I'll get him.
Is he leaving us? Oh, he's going to say hello to somebody over here.
Thank you.
many members we originally had. We started with 5. We went up to 7. We went to 8. That's the most we ever had. And, of course, we have 9 here tonight, which I'll explain. And we went back down to... Thank you.
Bye.